So we are going to pass to the next presentation, which will be presentation about the XBRL in the United Arab Emirates and a leap towards transparency. This will be presented by Mr. Mohamed Al-Hadari, who is the Deputy Chief Executive Officer of the authorities there, and also the chairman of the new jurisdiction, which has been set up some years ago. It will be after followed by a presentation by Mr. Ryan Lemand, the Dr. Ryan Lemand, sorry, he's from École Nationale Supérieure, ENS in Paris. And he's a senior economist advisor at the head of risk management at the Emirates Securities Commodity Authority. So please.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm delighted to be to the opportunity to be here today, and I would like to thank both XBRL International and XBRL Belgium to hosting us on this conference. The purpose of my quick speech is to announce to you today the next spring XBRL International conferences will be take place in United Arab Emirates in the city of Abu Dhabi in 2012. In fact, over the first several months, the Securities and Commodities Authority, the Abu Dhabi Exchange, and Dubai Financial Market, and several other stockholders have worked hard to pave the way for the introducing the XBRL in the United Arab Emirates. And hosting the XBRL International Conference in the Middle East will help us to market XBRL across all Arab countries. Also, I would like to share with you the progress of we made on the implementation of XBRL, the critical milestones of drafting the taxonomies for all the 10 sectors of United Arab Emirates listed companies has been completed earlier this month, and the market campaigns to support the pilot launch of XBRL is under the way and as scheduled. And now Dr. Ryan Lemand will present the key aspects of the XBRL UAE. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Tony, just like you, I was wondering if this podium can be adjusted downwards, not upwards. Usually I'm very tall, but it just doesn't show today. Well, thank you so much, Mr. Mohamed. I'm the XBRL project director in the UAE, and I'm here to tell you the story of what has been done in the UAE on the XBRL until today. I'm very delighted to say that the UAE in the near future will actually play an active role in sharing economic information with the global world, because until recently the UAE only had paper filings, so did not have actual electronic economic data to share with the global world. The objectives of implementing XBRL in the UAE were three strategic objectives. The first one is actually to generate economic data. Having the financial statements of one listed company is financial data. However, having the financial statements of all listed companies aggregated, this is economic data. So the first objective is to have economic data that reflect the status of the listed companies in the UAE. The second objective is more relevant to the exchanges. As you probably know, MSCI and FTSE give a rating to the different exchanges around the world. And the UAE exchanges have a rating of frontier markets, not yet emerging markets. This rating is based on a survey that FTSE and MSCI send to the investment professionals, and they vote for upgrading or not those markets. And the lack of data plays a role in this vote process. So having electronic data will help boost this voting process for the UAE exchanges to be upgraded to emerging markets, which would enhance liquidity and depth of markets. The third objective is to have more institutional investors in the exchanges, because basically when you have an exchange where you have a serious lack of electronic data, you only attract fast money or hot money or hedge funds. They come on an intraday basis or weekly basis. They punt around and then pull out of the market. However, when you have electronic data and a depth of data, then you'd attract more the long-term investors like the traditional portfolio managers who actually base their investments on an actual financial analysis. Before I start talking about the XBRL project, I would like to share with you how we used to do things until very recently. This work was started in September 2008. This is the first time where actual electronic data was born in the UAE. And I'm going to show you how the process is being done until now, actually, every quarter and every year, basically keying in every single financial statement of the listed companies in the UAE. So here it's an example about finding the total assets of a listed company called Emar, which is the one of the largest real estate companies in Dubai, listed in Dubai financial market. So basically, the first step, you have to go to the website of the market, of the exchange, Dubai Financial Market. You have to look for the financial statement. You have to download it, unzip it, open the PDF file, then look for the total assets. Here it is. And then obviously, because it's a PDF, you cannot copy it and paste it. You'll have to key it in manually. So here it is in the cell, under Excel. And the SCA risk management unit keys in 3,813 data points every quarter this way. So this is how it looks. That's one data point. This is the net assets of EMAR. So the operational objectives of XBRL in the UAE was, first of all, to implement an XBRL-enabled software solution for listed companies in both exchanges to submit their financial and non-financial disclosures. To create a taxonomy for UAE listed companies, and this would be based, this is based on IFRS, and extending it to accommodate the specificities that the listed companies in the UAE have. As you know, it's mostly petrochemical companies, Islamic companies, Islamic banks, and Islamic insurance companies. Also a platform to enable filers to file their financial reports, corporate announcements, as well as capital adequacy for brokers, okay? At the moment, the UAE brokers file their capital adequacy using an Excel file, and then it's linked to the database within the authorities' servers, and this is how the capital adequacy is calculated. So we're intending on using XBRL to calculate this capital adequacy and have this capital adequacy reported live intraday. Also, the regulators will be able to verify the compliance and adherence of all submissions, and external users obviously will be able to consume this data. Now, the approach is, to start with, that's really phase one, is to use iFile, which is an add-on that comes on Excel, which generates the instance documents. Most of the listed companies in the UAE use Excel as a start to generate their financial statements, so iFile would basically allow them to generate the instance document. Now, obviously, this is not an integrated approach, but in phase one, to market XBRL, we needed a bait approach, basically telling companies there's no cost, it's very easy, it takes just a couple of days of training, you'll use iFile, generates instance documents, and send it to the authority. Then on later stages and later phases, we're counting on enforcing more an integrated approach, so have the listed companies integrate the XBRL instance document generation into their ERPs. But this will come at a later stage once the listed companies have accepted XBRL and all fears surrounding XBRL and the costs around it have subsided. Also, the XBRL documents will be validated by the authority and by both markets. So the Securities and Commodities Authority is the federal regulator, and you have two markets, DFM and ADX, and this data will need to be validated by the three entities. So there will be a server within the Securities and Commodities Authority that would receive the instance documents and play a pass-through role to distribute this data to the DFM and ADX. Also, this is a new thing. We're counting on implementing a validation approach with the auditors. So the auditors will need to validate the XBRL document parallelly to validating the paper audited filing. We don't want to have any discrepancies between both. And then finally, the data will be stored within the SCA servers. So this is how the solution overview would look generally. So you have the validation engines, the compliance engines, this distribution engine, and then finally you have the ESCA report generation process. So it can be consumed within ESCA users on the right-hand side, on the upper part, and then on the lower part by investors. And obviously, on the left-hand side, the auditors will have a viewer as well to be able to validate this XBRL instance document. So the way the taxonomy was designed was basically use IFRS 2011 as the building block. So 80% of the taxonomy is basically IFRS 2011. The second building block is the SCA, ADX, and DFM specific requirements. The third block are the commonly reported industry elements we usually observe in the UAE, like for the petrochemical companies. And finally, we will be allowing company extensions. However, it will not be a free extension process. Each listed company will have to submit a request to extend. This will be submitted to the taxonomy committee and approved or not. So there will not be free extensions. Also, this taxonomy will be reviewed twice a year. So basically, it can happen that a company submits a request for an extension, and then the review is very close, like in a couple of months. Then it can be included in the review of this taxonomy, so we won't have to use an extension. As Mr. Mohammed mentioned, we're very delighted to announce that on May 5th, we have completed the draft taxonomy with the help of Iris, who's the software vendor, for all 10 sectors in the UAE. And this includes the banking sector, Islamic and non-Islamic, as well as number 9, insurance, Islamic and non-Islamic. We reviewed approximately 4,000 items to finalize this this draft taxonomy. So this work is behind us today. Those are the different phases of the project. So the taxonomy is completed on May 5th. Then we'll move into the application development, so the web, the iFile, etc. Then the first testing will be done on July 31st, the user acceptance in August, and we go live on September 1st. We're going to have a pilot group of 20 listed companies, which are the top 20 companies on both markets, who will file their fourth quarter results using XBRL. So basically, the unique features of this project is having multiple exchanges working with the regulator. We are really working as one team, as if we're working for the same organization. And we're collaborating to generate this system across the three organizations. The second unique feature is having an auditor interface, which would allow auditors to validate the XBRL documents and avoid any discrepancies. The third one is the corporate actions, which are part of the filing requirements, as well as the corporate governance reports, which at the start will be reported as simple text blocks. We're hoping it will be probably the first implementation of IFRS 2011 in the taxonomy. We don't think anybody has done it before until now, since the IFRS 2011 was validated on March 25th. Also, the taxonomy will have both languages, Arabic and English, and this is the first active use of Arabic labels by a capital market. Also, companies will be allowed to extend the taxonomy with the regulator's approval. And finally, the Islamic and non-Islamic taxonomy for banking and insurance sectors is also a relative first. And here we had to reconcile the two schools of Islamic financing. As you know, there are two schools. So we tried to take the overlap between both, again, in a pyramid approach. So take the building block as the common ones. And then we left the, the conflictual ones to be extended by the specific companies, knowing that those extensions would be very limited because the companies, the listed companies that follow a specific school, their number is quite limited, actually. So that's it for me for now. Thank you very much for your attention.